In the last video, we had completed meiosis 1, and now we're ready to go into meiosis 2. And you might be wondering, well, hey, you know, after mitosis, we went back into our interphase. Is there kind of a rest period between our two phases of meiosis? And the answer is sometimes. There can be a rest period where you have an interphase 2. And that will depend on the type of cell and the species and all of that, but it is possible. So I'll actually put that over here. So we could have an interphase 2. So interphase 2, which you could kind of view as a rest period. But then we get into meiosis 2, which will allow us to complete all of meiosis. So you could imagine meiosis 2 starts with prophase 2. And in prophase 2, now I'm dealing with two cells here. So in prophase 2, and I'm going to do it for both of the cells that I have outside after I finished meiosis 1. So in prophase 2, so that's one of the cells. I'm not going to have space to draw it properly. So let me draw it. So let me draw this one first. So this is one of the cells right over here. And then this is the other cell right over here. In prophase 2, just like in prophase 1 and just like in prophase and mitosis, and let me write the phases here. This is prophase 2 we're talking about. Prophase 2, your nuclear envelope dissolves again. So let me show a dissolving nuclear envelope. So your nuclear envelope dissolves again. And your chromosomes once again condense, I guess into their denser form. So it's gonna look like this, and this on this side. It has a little bit of the magenta that was from the chromosomal crossover back in prophase 1. And then you have this character right over here that is shorter. You have this chromosome right over here, and it had a little orange section from the chromosomal crossover, just like this. And then you have the shorter orange chromosome just like that. So they have condensed. And you actually, each of these cells now will have duplicate centrosomes. So the centrosomes have replicated, and they will start to migrate to opposite ends of the cell. So once again, very strong analogy, especially to, frankly, prophase from mitosis. So now let's keep going. We're now ready to go to metaphase two. And let me draw my two cells. So this is one of them, and this is the other. Let me draw an arrow here so you can see that we are entering into another phase. So we are entering into another phase, metaphase 2. And you can just imagine, it's very similar to what happens in metaphase and mitosis. And actually, all of meiosis 2 is very similar to what happens in mitosis. So in metaphase 2, our centrosomes have migrated to the poles. So our centrosomes have migrated to the poles. And I'm going to do it twice because I'm now dealing with two different cells. My nuclear membrane is now disappeared. And I have my now dense chromosomes lining up along the equator here. So this magenta one, it'll line up right over here. So it might look like that. And actually, let me draw all the magenta ones now since I have my magenta color selected. So this is the longer one and this one. And this had a little bit of orange in it. Has a little bit of the orange here, and then I had the shorter orange chromosome. And on this cell I had the larger orange chromosome. So it had a little bit of pink on it. And of course you have your microtubules that are, yeah, I've been doing that in blue, so let me continue to do it in blue. That are pushing the centrosomes apart, but are also attaching to the chromosomes at the kinetochores. So there you go, and remember this right over here where the two sister chromatids attach, those are our centromeres. So let me just draw it all out like this. So it might be something like that. And now we're ready for anaphase two, and you can imagine what's about to happen. Things are about to pull apart. And once again, this is analogous to what happens in anaphase in mitosis. So anaphase two. Anaphase two. I'm gonna draw all my cells again. It's taking me twice as long because I have to do it for twice as many cells. So that's one cell there. This is another cell here. This is, I got a centrosome here, centrosome here, centrosome here, centrosome here. And then the key here is, and this is why it's like mitosis and not like anaphase and meiosis one, is instead of, or like in mitosis, we're now going to split the sister chromatids, so they now become two daughter chromosomes. When they're connected, they're viewed as sister chromatids that make up one chromosome, but now they're getting pulled apart. So this one might get pulled in this direction, and then this one might get pulled in this direction. It has a little bit of the magenta right over here, and then one of the sister chromatids, which would now be a daughter chromosome, going in upwards, and one of them going downwards. And let me draw all the microtubules here, all the microtubules that are super involved in all of this work of getting things to the right sides of the cells. And this is gonna happen in this cell as well. So this one might be going down here, and this one is moving up here. And this one had a little chunk of orange on it. So let me draw that, a little chunk of orange. And then once again, one of the formerly sister chromatids, now daughter chromosomes, going up there, and now going down over here. And let me draw all of the microtubules that are really, well, I've said it multiple times, super involved in the movement going on. They're elongating, there's these motor proteins that are moving the chromosomes along. Once again, they're connected at the kinetochores right over here. Connected at the kinetochores right over there. And now we're almost done. We're ready to move into telophase two. So we're now going to go into telophase two. Telophase two, where my two cells are now becoming four cells. So telophase two, I'm gonna show the cytokinesis starting to happen. So telophase two, so turning into four cells, starting to show the cytokinesis happening. In this cell up here, I have this character and has a little bit of magenta right over here. That's this right over there, and then you have the shorter magenta one. And actually they're starting to unravel into their chromatin form, so maybe I'll draw that a little bit. And then this one right over here is starting to unravel into its chromatin form, and so is that one. I'm gonna do that in that magenta color. Starting to unravel into its chromatin form. I'll do it over here. This one is starting to unravel, and so is this one. So is I'm having trouble changing colors. And so is that one. And then up here, this one's starting to unravel, this one over here. And this longer, mostly magenta one is also starting to unravel. You start having your nuclear envelope form again. So your nuclear envelope is forming again. Your microtubules are dissolving. Let me draw the centrosomes. They're outside of the nuclear envelope. And of course, you are finally dividing the cells. Your cytokinesis happens. So now you have your four cells that each have a haploid number. They each have two chromosomes. Remember, your diploid number was four. The germ cell had four chromosomes, two pairs of homologous chromosomes. Now, each of your resulting gametes, these are now gametes now, these are gametes, they have a haploid number. But we started with a haploid number at the beginning of meiosis II. So that's why meiosis II is often compared to mitosis. So let me make this clear. This right over here is meiosis II because it preserves the number of chromosomes, just like mitosis. So this is meiosis II right over here. Meiosis II. We started with a haploid number and we finished with a haploid number just like this. And now these gametes are ready for some fertilization. And it's important to realize now these each have two chromosomes, and these are not homologous chromosomes. These are coding for different genes. But then they will, each of these have the potential to fuse with, if this is a sperm cell, then this could fuse with an egg, and then together they can create a diploid number of chromosomes. It could have the full complement of homologous pairs. But that's what these are for sexual reproduction.